Hi there, Diederik again. Let's get you started with your GOM Inspect suite. In this getting started, I'll be showing you how we can work with trend projects in GOM Inspect suite. Feel free to pause at any point to follow along, and we have some chapter segments if you wish to skip ahead. Let's get started. To show you what we can do with a trend project in GOM Inspect suite, I have this project right here. This was made with GOM Inspect Professional, as we need the professional version to create trend projects, but we will use GOM Inspect Suite to review, to edit, and to modify to our liking. What I'll show you now is the trend capabilities. What does that mean? We have combined 5 different scans into one project. And here at the bottom, I could select my different parts, go through, and see live the changes of all these different parts and the deviation they had towards a CAD file. I could change my legend, because maybe I'm more interested in the minimum values, the maximum values, or for example, the range of my complete part. So all 5 parts are taken into account, showing me the range that I have, which is very valuable to validate my production process. Or maybe I'm more interested in statistic analysis like CP value, PP, CPK, which are shown in color. What I could also do is change the visibility of these labels. So instead of seeing it only for one part, I could change the visibility to a trend label, and look what happens. All 5 values are shown on this graph, showing me the min, the max values, the average, the sigma. Or opening up the table gives me access to even more functionalities, which I can even export into CSV. When I look back at the color map, which I made before, I was always looking between the CAD file and the scan data. But maybe I'm interested in the difference between part 1 and part 2. Well, that's also possible in GOM Inspect Suite. I could go to my Manage Stages and set that very first part as a reference. When I do this, I can go to my second part, and in this color map, I see the difference between part 1 and part 2. Which could show me the influence of a material change, a different setting in the production process, and thus understanding how I'm making my parts better, or in this case, worse. The last thing which I would like to show you is how easy we can add another stage. Here, part 6, I could drag and drop into GOM Inspect Suite, but here I get the notify to do these things, I need a professional. But remember, I could always apply for the free trial version and allowing me these functionalities and build further on my trend projects. So this was it. We used GOM Inspect Suite to review a trend project. We were able to add inspections, change inspections, all in the free software GOM Inspect Suite. If you experience anything different from what you've seen here, if you have any questions or issues with GOM Inspect Suite, like always, reach out to us via support@handsonmetrology.com. For more getting started information, please check out the other videos. Thanks for watching. I'll see you next time.